Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and WWDC, or the Worldwide Developer Conference, is only 1 week away, and next Monday we should see iOS 14, watchOS 7, and some other hardware for the very first time. So I want to talk about that, but first, before I talk about that and other future Apple products, I want to talk about something that they released already today, which was really interesting. So Apple updated the options of the 16-inch MacBook Pro with an all-new AMD Radeon Pro 5600M GPU with 8 gigabytes of HBM2 memory. And this should be a 70% increase or so over the previous GPU. So this is not for everyone. It's for a specific audience and costs $700 for this option. So it's going to have to be very specific to what you do, and you'll know if you already need this, but it's a pretty expensive option. Also, the Mac Pro is getting upgrade kits for its storage. So you can expand up to 8 terabytes, which this is directly from Apple, and it's nice to see them do this. So that'll be an option. These things are available today. So this is really nice to see Apple continuously update things. And this makes me more excited for WWDC, seeing that they're pushing out updates before it or so soon before it, meaning they might have a lot to show. And so the first thing that sort of leaked this past week was iOS 14's beta profile. Now, I was kind of skeptical about this at first, but quite a few people messaged me and said, no, I actually got this, but I wasn't able to install it. So Apple quickly made it unavailable, and apparently this is the real beta profile. This is just a screenshot of it someone sent to me, but it looks like this was the real deal. So maybe this was just Apple testing a few things and they accidentally leaked it out, but it seems like it'll be here on Monday. We'll be able to install it after the keynote of WWDC. So we'll have that keynote at 1 p.m. Eastern time. You'll be able to watch it usually if everything's the same, either on their app for the WWDC conference or on apple.com, which we normally can see it there. Now, aside from the leak of the beta profile, there are also going to be some new emojis showing up in iOS 14. So here's some of them. You'll see there's bubble tea and some others, and there will be a bunch of others. And this is just to comply with Unicode standards. This is pretty standard across the industry with iOS and Android and Microsoft as well. All the time, there are updates to Unicode with new emoji. And so Apple and Google and Microsoft push out updates with the new emoji. And this is just some of them that you can expect with updates with iOS. Now, of course, with watchOS 7, I expect sleep mode because you could keep the watch on and then it could monitor your movements, your heart rate, and maybe your O2 saturation. This seems like it's going to be a feature in watchOS 7, but you'll probably need a new watch with a new sensor on it for that to work. So you would need a new O2 saturation sensor on the back of the Apple Watch for that to work properly. And I would expect that with watchOS 7, but also needing a new watch. So maybe we'll see some new hardware with a sixth generation or Series 6 Apple Watch, but it's hard to say at this point. But the thing I'm most excited for personally is a new iMac design that should look more like this iPad. So it looks like there's going to be a new iMac, and probably it will have that new GPU that's available in the MacBook Pro today. And you could have a new iMac that looks similar to this iPad Pro or these renderings here. So it would look just like an iMac Pro, but propped up and on a stand that would be included. Hopefully we'll be able to upgrade a few things within it, but it's hard to say at this point what Apple's going to do with that. And it looks like there's more and more confirmation that we're going to be transitioning to ARM MacBooks or ARM Macs over the next couple of years. Now, what that means is Apple's going to create their own CPUs for MacBooks and Mac products, just like they do with iPhones. And they've gotten very good at it, and they have some great engineers that develop chips. And so they would transition all of their Mac products over to this new processor because Intel seems to be falling behind, just like PowerPC CPUs did years ago. So Apple transitioned from PowerPC to Intel products, and that took about a year to move all of the different Macs over to it. Then after that transition, we were on Intel, and then we could do things like boot camp. But if we have a new ARM Mac situation, not sure if boot camp will work, but we should have some better performance and much better battery life in things like MacBooks and MacBook Pro. So I would expect maybe a new 12-inch MacBook Pro, or at least them to start in a MacBook Air or something like that with the new CPUs that they have, maybe an A14 chip dedicated to MacBooks themselves. So whether or not we'll see those right away, it's hard to say. But if Apple does what they did previously, expect it to take 1 to 2 years to transition fully. Now, there was some interesting information today from John Prosser about Apple working on foldable phones. Now, I expected this. Apple's always trying out new things, and their foldable phone, according to John Prosser, is more like what we saw from Microsoft with the Surface Duo. Not a screen that extends and folds physically, but instead two iPhones next to each other, but with a continuous screen because the tolerances would be close enough. So it would look as though it's one screen, but it's actually two, and then they would fold. That could be really interesting for an iPad. I would expect Apple to be working on different prototypes, but when that would come out is really hard to say. And so I look forward to that because I don't really see a use personally for me for foldable phones. And in fact, I asked many of you what you thought in a poll on Twitter, and 2,379 of you voted, and 78% of you said you would not be interested in a foldable iPhone. So it'd be really interesting to see what Apple does with this. And I'd love to see if Apple actually makes a foldable phone, how it could be more usable than maybe what Samsung has done. I love the innovation that Samsung's pushing that sort of pushes everyone else. And so hopefully we'll see something from Apple, at least maybe in a couple of years. It's hard to say. Now, there were some molds that were leaked of iPhone 12. And so it looks like the notch is going to stay. Whether or not it gets smaller or not is still up in the air. But it looks like iPhone 12 is definitely going to have squared off edges, similar to that of the iPhone 5. So just like this iPhone 5, it would have some more squared off edges, have this look, which I prefer this greatly over what we have currently. So it's easier to hold on to as well. But maybe we'll see this sort of design come back with iPhone 12. It looks pretty much confirmed. At this point, all of the tooling has to be created and everything to mass produce iPhone. So I would expect this to be the new look of iPhone when it comes out later this year, probably in October. And then there's a couple other things as well. iPad Air apparently is going to get a redesign later this year with USB-C charging, as well as Touch ID under the screen, or at least that's what people are saying. So instead of having Face ID, it would have Touch ID under the display somewhere, and then you'd be able to unlock your device. I'm not sure if Apple will do this, but I'd love to see that. And then, of course, I would love to see everything transition to USB-C because it's just easier to have a Mac charger, iPhone, and iPad charger all be the same thing. That's something I personally prefer. I know not everyone does. And it looks like not only will there be an iPad Air redesign, but also an iPad mini that might match this as well. So there's some additional information that's been leaked about that, but it's hard to say. And then finally, the Magic Keyboard that I like so well for the iPad Pro may be having a variant coming to the iPad. Now, the only issue with the Magic Keyboard is its price. It's very expensive, and while it's very functional and great to use, at its $350 price for the 12.9-inch variant, it's just not reasonable to pair with a $329 iPad. So I would expect a less expensive version, maybe that is maybe lacks some functionality or something else. But hopefully we'll see more options for the iPad in the future. But let me know what you're looking most forward to at WWDC in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.